Welcome back, guys. Dunlop's back in action once again. Getting the fishing rods out to try and catch some fish. Because why not? Why not try and catch some fish? I've come down to Derby Haven here. This is a spot where you can dig some nice worms for bait. The weather's been a bit shit recently, not going to lie. Might be quite hard to find any bait. The tide is a 1.2 low, so it's not the lowest of lows, but we should still, fingers crossed, be able to find some bait. So it's just started spitting. Don't know if you can see that on the screen, but that ain't going to stop me because I've got some waterproof kecks on. I'm going to bang a waterproof jacket on, and I might even bang the head strap on, get you some digging for you. And then if the weather plays okay, I mean, if it's a bit spitty, I don't mind. I'll still go fishing. If it's torrential, I'll probably hold out and save the bait. But we're just going to have to see how it goes. So without any further ado, I'll bang you on the head strap. We'll get down there, get the fork, and dig some baits up. Let's get out of here. So just making our way down the beach now. Got me tub. Yeah, it's only a little tub. You know, I'm only getting bait for myself. You know, I'm only going fishing on my own. Don't need to take a bucket. What's the point? Just means you got to carry it around everywhere. So, little tub it is. Got a fork for the job. Now, we just got to find some worms. Don't know if you can see here, but there is some casts here starting to show already. Who knows, might find some ragworm. That'd be nice. Oh, God. Look at that. That's cool, isn't it? Look at that. That's a little sea urchin. Or something like that. I hope you can see that because I can't take the camera off my head, but look at that beast. That is awesome. Anyway, we've not come for urchins today. We've come for worms. So I'll turn you off until I get digging. Plenty of clams everywhere, actually, look. Loads of clams about. Interesting. Maybe I should use some clams someday for fishing, who knows. If anyone's used any before, had some good results, leave me a comment because, you know, wouldn't mind digging some up if they are a good bait, I could try it out. And yeah, I'll speak to you soon. Here we go, so we had a couple of digs. This is the target, this is what we're looking for. This is a lugworm. It's not the biggest lugworm in the world, you know, but that, to be fair, a couple of them on a hook would be an all right bait. I think he's pretty much dead, which isn't good, but we'll bang him in the box. There we go. One down. Let's keep going. There's one right there. Somewhere. Here he is. That's another one there. That's an all right size. That's not a bad size worm right there. That's definitely a sort of ones we're after. They do get a bit bigger than that, but if you can get some like that, or to be fair, if you can get them all like that, I'll be pretty happy with that. So let's keep this action going and see what else we can produce, eh? Not really sure what that one is, but it's a bit too small, a bit too skinny. Not sure what it is. Looks like it could be a ragworm or something. There's a nice one. Another nice one there. And another. This is the ones we're looking for, guys. This right here. This here. That. Let me just give him a rinse for you, but this, that's a prime bait. That right there, that's a cracking worm for bait, that is. Cracking bait. So, I'm going to keep digging this spot a bit more, then we'll move on. Right, so, but about half an hour's worth of digging now. This is what we've got. We've got some nice little lugs here. We did manage to pick up a couple of rag. Not many though, just a couple. There's one there. So, yeah, not too bad baits, really. Enough for a session. That'll do me, because it's only me fishing, so it's starting to rain a bit. So, I think we get out of here, go try and find some swell. We need some swell, because if there's no swell, there's no fish. So I could do with finding some swell here. Too calm. So let's put these in the van, get me in the van, get the heaters on, have a refreshment, and then we'll come up with a plan. But it is starting to rain a little bit heavier now, so I don't know, we'll have to wait and see what happens. Maybe it will knock off, maybe it won't, who knows. Let's get back. Well, I'm not gonna lie, it's absolutely chucking it down. Look at the state of me, soaked already. So I thought, you know what, I might as well get them rods out for a blast. There's not much swell, to be honest, and to be honest with you, I've got a feeling that we could just be getting attacked by some little pin whiting. If that's the case, we'll just fish it for an hour or so till it gets dark, and then we'll just jib it off, save the bait for another day. However, you never know, there could be some decent fish around, might get a bass or something, or a nice flatty, so that's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna fish light. I've got one rod here, the tripod bait, bag of gear, bag some juice in there. I'm gonna bring the gopes with me, even though it's gonna get soaking wet, so I apologize for the audio. I apologize for any of the shit footage that I might get, but it's the best I can do. It's either this or sit in the house and watch another fucking shitty series on Netflix. So I know what I'd rather be doing. So let's get down there, get a rod in the water. Fingers crossed we can catch something. Woohoo! So we're down here at the beach. It's absolutely horrendous. I've not brought a chair with me because I don't really fancy sitting down in all the shit. So I think I'll just have to use whatever I'm using out of this bag and then put it back on. So that's just what's gonna go down. Grab a weight. What's that? It's a 3 ounce. That'll probably do, to be honest. That should dig in nicely. Let's try and find a trace in this bag. What's on here? She's a bit rusty, but she should be good to go. Let's try and get this unwound without tangling her up too much. Too late, already tangled. Oh, this is an absolute write-off, guys. Look at this. Oh, there we go. There we go. This is just a simple trace, just two hooks on it to the main line. Weight clip here. Just one that I made up, dead simple. It's the only sort of traces that I seem to make up for the beaches, but they seem to work, so that's all that matters, eh? Hands are a bit cold already. That's her on there. Let's attach this on. You never know. You might even just... I'm probably going to blank, to be honest, but you don't know unless you give it a go, do you? So that's what we're doing. We're giving it a go. Close this bag up. Get it back on the back. Rod just slammed over, and look what we've got. Here he is. Just give him a quick rinse off for you. So the perseverance paid off. The first fish is a lovely little bass. It just slammed the rod over. I didn't have the camera on, so I couldn't get it, unfortunately, but I'm gonna have to put him back. He's been out of the water for a minute or so because I had to put a new battery in, so let's get him back in quickly. We don't want to hurt it. That's a cracking first fish of the session. One thing I've noticed is I'm really struggling to keep this bait on while I'm trying to cast it past the breakers. Seems like every time I try and get it just past, it's just enough force to just crack the bait off. So I've cast it out there, majority of the bait come off, but it's still got some on there, so I'm just gonna see if that picks anything up. I'll give it 10-15 minutes. If it doesn't, I'll just have to keep putting bait on, casting it out until I get it somewhere where I think the fish are. But yeah, I don't know, it's pretty tough going. But hey, at least we caught one, we didn't blank. We got a bass, that's the main thing. That's the target species, really. So yeah, starting to get a bit darker now. Probably can't really tell on the GoPro because the old, the auto light thingy-majiggy, whatever you want to call it. So yeah, fingers crossed we can catch another one. As you can see, that was the end of my session there. Ran out of baits. What a fantastic session that was, though. Great fun going out digging the bait, catching the fish. So we had a bass, coal fish, and three or four rocklings, I think. Three bearded rockling, I'm not sure what the other one was. But yeah, not a bad session, really. So I'm going to end it here. Thanks for watching. If you want to see some more videos coming up, hit the subscribe button. And yeah, we'll see you in the next one. Woohoo!